Additional depreciation, Section 32, Subsection 1, Clause 2, Subclause A. What are the conditions to claim additional depreciation? Now, as I told you earlier, additional depreciation is in addition to the normal depreciation which an assessee is entitled to on a particular asset. In order to claim this additional depreciation, there are certain conditions. Okay? The first condition is that the assessee should be engaged in the business of manufacture or production of any article or thing. Or in other words, it should be an industrial undertaking, right? Which is engaged into the business of manufacture and production of any article or thing. If, let's say for example, if you are in the service sector, you will not be entitled to additional depreciation, right? So the assessee or the person who is making a claim to have this additional depreciation has to be engaged in the business of manufacture or production of any article or thing. That is about the first condition, right? Now let us look at the second one. Once you are an assessee who is engaged in the business of manufacture or production of any article or thing, let's say the first condition is manufacture, yes, no. If it is no, there is no additional depreciation. Once you are into manufacturing, the second condition is new plant and machinery acquired and installed after 31st March 2005. So once you are engaged into manufacture, the second condition is you should acquire plant and machinery. And what plant and machinery? It has to be a new plant and machinery, which is both acquired and installed after 31st March 2005. What this means is that if this is acquired before 31st March 2005, even though the installation might happen after 31st March 2005, still no depreciation will be available as additional depreciation. Both acquisition as well as installation have to be after 31st March 2005. Once you satisfy both these conditions, condition number one, you are an assessee engaged in the manufacture. Second, you install new plant and machinery, which is acquired and installed after 31st March 2005, a sum equal to 20% or 10% of the actual cost. Okay, so the rate of additional depreciation is 20%, right? But if the asset is put to use for less than 180 days, this is something which you are going to understand in the next video, you know. If the asset is put to use for less than 180 days, then the depreciation is available at 50% of the rate or 10%. And 10% of what? Of the actual cost of such plant and machinery, okay, shall be allowed as a depreciation deduction in the year when the machinery is first put to use. Okay, so let's say for example, let me give you an example here that will clarify things. Suppose I acquired installed. If I acquired the plant, let's say on 33-2005 and installed it on 1-4-2005, right? Will I be entitled to additional depreciation? No. Why? Because the acquisition has not happened after 31st March 2005. That's the condition which was there, right? Acquired and installed after 31st March 2005. Second, acquisition happened on 1-4-2005, right? And installation also happened, let's say, on the same date. Because both the acquisition and the installation happened after 31st March 2005, I am entitled to additional depreciation. Now, if, let's say, for example, the acquisition happened on 1-4-2005, but the installation happened on, let's say 30th November 2005. Then if I see the asset is put to use for financial year 04-05, the asset is put to use only for December, which is 31 days, January, plus February, plus March, okay, or 121 days. whenever the asset is put to use for less than how many days? Now remember, this is what we had discussed earlier, less than 180 days. Then depreciation is allowed at 50%, right? You are entitled to half a percent half the year depreciation. So in this case, the depreciation shall be allowed at 10%, whereas in this case, you will be allowed depreciation at the rate of 20%, right? So this is basically something which this box discusses. Sum equal to 20% or 10% of the actual cost of such machinery or plant shall be allowed as depreciation deduction in the year when the machinery is first put to use. Now please note that this depreciation of additional depreciation is allowed only once. Okay, you can't claim it in every year. It has to be allowed only in the year when the asset is first put to use. And when the put to use is less than 180 days, depreciation is 10%. Also, one other thing which you need to note here is, let's say you acquire asset for 100. Okay, your normal depreciation is 15. Your additional depreciation, let's say at 20%, is 120. Right? This value of 20 is also to be reduced from the cost of asset. So 100 minus 15 minus 20 will give you 65. Next year you will be entitled to depreciation on 65 and not 100 minus 15, 85. Right? So 65 is the correct value for depreciation for next year and not 85. Right? A simple thing, but just for the sake of clarity, I thought let me just bring this point out to you. Now, even in order to claim additional depreciation, there are certain conditions which are available. That we'll see in the next video or the next slide.